Mark Arnaldo reporting from Gen Con 2015. I'm here at the Upper Deck booth and I'm sitting down with Danny, who is one of the designers of Legendary Encounters Predator, a new iteration of the Legendary system, specifically of the Legendary Encounters system that I enjoyed very, very much last year when the Alien game came out. And Danny has agreed to tell us a little bit about Legendary Encounters Predator. Thank you, Danny.
With the Predator game, it's really two games in one. Half of the game you can play as the humans, like Arnold Schwarzenegger and Danny Glover and those characters, and you're trying to work together to survive the Predator hunting you and killing you off. This works mechanically the same way as the Aliens game does. In fact, it's fully compatible. You can mix and match between the two games. You can mix Ripley with Arnold, and you can fight aliens and predators all in the same deck. There's a few new twists, like the Predator has a mechanic where he can mark certain players and then do nasty things to them. And there's some new keyword effects. And there's a secondary way to win the game now. You can defeat the Predator, or for example, in the first movie, you can get to the chopper and escape that way, which is another option. The other half of the game is actually playing as the Predators, and it's a full game. It's actually more cards than the cooperative mode of the game. And this is a new experience that's somewhat halfway between the Aliens cooperative experience and the Marvel Legendary version, where you're playing, competing for points. So I'm going to talk mostly about that and those new mechanics. So the big difference between the playing as Predators and playing as humans, first of all, is that as Predators, the prey deck, as we call it, instead of the enemy deck or the hive deck, the cards come into play face up. You don't have to scan. The Predator can sort of see where everybody is. There are a few effects that might turn a card face down, but that's a minor detail. So the Predators can kill the prey, and then in this game, because you're competing with the other Predators to get the most honor, you take the prey that you killed and you put him in your trophy room, and maybe you polish his skull and something like that from the movie. So you're playing against the other Predators. The other major new mechanics are, there's no missions or locations in this mode. Instead, there's two new mechanics. I'm just going to sort of show you a couple cards. Mm-hmm. One are called gear. There's just different types of gear. During the game, this is the prey deck. There's enemies in here. There's also these gear up cards. And whenever one of these is revealed, you draw a random gear from the pile and attach it to the rightmost prey. And then it gives him a special property, as well as it's worth some honor. This blue number is how much honor the various cards are worth. And when you kill a character, you take the gear as well. So you get lots of variety and things that can happen. The second new card type are called dangers. And these represent how the humans are setting traps and trying to fight back against you as you're hunting them. And these actually go into the wilds, which is sort of the complex equivalent for Predator. And they stay up here and they sort of move like prey do. You can avert the danger by paying with the stars, the recruit points, that amount to then put the danger in your trophy room. So basically you can earn honor in various ways. You can kill people, you can
avoid
danger, you can avoid danger. If a danger card makes it all the way to the combat zone, it's immediately discarded and then you draw one of these. These are traps. Uh-huh. So traps, whoever's turn it is the unfortunate one who gets stuck in the trap. The trap card just goes in front of you and will stay in front of you for the rest of the game. You can disable it by spending stars to equal to the number and then get honor. But meanwhile, while it's in front of you, it's doing some nasty effect to you. It's making it so you can't recruit characters, or they're more expensive, or you're taking a strike every turn, that kind of thing. So that's how traps work. One of the other main mechanics is these are some of the Predator avatars. Mm-hmm. There's five different Predator avatars you can choose from. There's 10 different human roles. The Predators can't normally fight each other. They're there to sort of compete to fight the prey, but some cards have the dual keyword. And when you play a card with a dual keyword, it lets you attack another Predator by spending attack points equal to their defense. So it's a way to fight each other. When you attack another Predator, they have to draw a strike. There's two types of strikes in the game. There's the types of strikes that you're familiar with from Aliens, which just do damage and they just go on your avatar just like before. And then there's dishonor strikes. So you can see they have the minus honor number. And they will subtract from your victory point total at the end. there's also two different ways to get rid of these strikes. There's two new simple keywords. Basically, there's cards that say heal one, heal two, and you can stack those together to get rid of that much damage. Similarly, there's cards that say restore one, restore two, and you can use those to get rid of dishonor. When the game ends in one of two ways. When there's one ultimate prey in the deck, it's going to be, you know, Arnold Dutch in the first movie and Danny Glover in the second movie. When the ultimate prey is killed, the game just ends immediately, and then you total up how much honor you've earned to see who the winner is. The other way the game ends is if a predator gets killed. If a predator gets killed, they basically type in their self-destruct, and then each other predator has one more turn before they have to run away from the blast. During that turn, they might kill the ultimate prey, they might get killed themselves. When a predator gets killed, you can see right here that each predator avatar is worth 3 honor itself. That means if you survive the game, you get 3 extra honor. If you get killed, your avatar goes face down, you don't get those 3 points. You can definitely win the game and still be killed, because gaining honor is more important than surviving.
Interesting.
The best part of that, in my opinion, is if you are dueling another predator and you cause them to draw a strike that kills them, you actually get to take their avatar and put it in your trophy room, so you have a predator as your trophy. So that's the main thing going on with the competitive version of the game, where you're playing as predators. The last thing is you can mix the Predator and Alien games together to play as predators and hunt aliens. So this is sort of a combination between how fighting the aliens works in Aliens and fighting how playing as predators works here. You play with aliens that come face up, except there are lots of effects now that turn them face down. And then it's the same deal. You're playing for honor to kill the aliens. They're just a lot tougher than the human prey.
Sounds absolutely great. Wow, I'm very excited to try this one. I haven't tried it yet, but absolutely. I like the old game and I like the new things that you mentioned that this adds to the system. I like the increased number of options in particular.
Yeah.
All right. Thank you very much,
Danny.
You.